The eyes of many in Congress fixed on the border after the confrontation between Border Patrol agents and hundreds of migrants. President Trump is renewing his demand to get funding for his border wall and threatening to shut down the government if he doesn't get it. I sat down with Senator Bernie Sanders from Vermont to discuss this and his new book, Where We Go From Here, 2 Years in the Resistance. So, Senator, you note in your book that you are the son of an immigrant, as you say, who came to this country with limited education and who might have been denied entrance in Trump's America. As we look at what's happening over the border right now in Tijuana, 5,000 to 9,000 migrants there waiting in a stadium seeking asylum, do you think they all have a credible claim for asylum?
No, I don't. And I think you have to look at it case by case. But I think what is most important is this country finally is going to have to deal with comprehensive immigration reform. You got close to 2 million young people in this country who are raised in this country, who know America is their only home, who are in the DACA program, but were scared to death of being deported. Nobody thinks that makes sense. So the time is long overdue, and I hope that with Democrats now in control over the House, we're going to be moving forward to serious, comprehensive immigration reform and a path toward citizenship. What we do not want to do is demonize desperate men, women, and children who are leaving the horror of Central America, who are looking for asylum.
Would you be supportive of at least listening to an idea of a Remain in Mexico policy where they could apply for asylum in the U.S.?
I am 100% supportive of comprehensive immigration reform. But, you know, while we're talking about people at the border, that's very important. There was a report, as you know, that just came out last week from 13 government agencies, which is dealing with the crisis facing us in terms of climate change.
Yep.
And what these agencies are telling us, if we do not get our act together and cut in a significant way carbon emissions, what you're going to be looking at are more wildfires like we have seen in California. You're going to see more rising sea levels. You're going to see more drought and more flooding. We have got to address that issue.
And that was the report. It was released by the Trump administration on the Friday after Thanksgiving.
Reluctantly released by the Trump administration.
Maybe on a Friday after Thanksgiving to minimize the impact it had. But my question for you is, with only a Democratic House, a Republican Senate, and a Republican president, what legislation? What do you want to see politicians in Washington do practically now?
But you see, you're using the word practically. Do you know what the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change said? They said that if we don't get our act together within 12 years, not a long period of time, there's going to be irreparable harm to this planet. So the point is, the American people have got to stand up and say that for the sake of their children and their grandchildren, we are going to have to take on the greed of the fossil fuel industry, who consider their short-term profits more important than the kind of lives my grandchildren are going to have.
You don't have to convince me that it's a serious issue. You have to convince Republicans in the Senate and Republicans in the White House.
No, I have to convince the American people to tell Republicans. So we have an international crisis. We've got to work with other countries around the world. And here's the good news, John. When we do that, we're going to create millions of jobs through increasing energy efficiency and moving toward wind, solar, and other sustainable energy. Look, here's the point. The scientists have told us, despite Trump's absurd thought that this is a hoax, that the future of the planet is at stake. Mm-hmm. Okay? Not a debatable issue to my mind. So we have got to have the courage to take on the greed of the fossil fuel industry. And by the way, if the House can send us a serious bill, I think you will be surprised at the number of Republicans who will not choose to be voting against
it. You just brought up the president there. In your book, you note sitting at the inauguration, listening to his inaugural address, and you noted it made you remark to yourself on what a phony and demagogue he is. Let me read you a passage here. Other than his racism and xenophobia, it's not clear that he really has any strong beliefs other than those that are politically expedient.
Did I say that?
You wrote that.
Well, it sounds good to me. I think it's right.
What did you mean?
Look. He has no political belief. He is a total phony and a political opportunist. I don't know if people know this. He now condemns legislation that I introduced called Medicare for All. Earlier in his life, he supported Medicare for All. This guy actually supported a tax on wealth. He was pro-choice. But he moves with the wind, and right now he is an extreme right-winger because he thinks that's how you get votes. And what he is doing, which really disturbs me very much, above and beyond tax breaks for billionaires, above and beyond trying to throw 32 million people off of health insurance, all of which he is doing, He is doing what no president in modern history has done, and really trying to divide the American people up based on the color of our skin or the country we came from or our religion or our sexual orientation. That is outrageous. And what that book is about is what I and other progressives have been doing over the last 2 years, to bring people together, not only in opposition to Trump, but to create an agenda that makes sense to farmers in Iowa and in Nebraska, where we are coming together around ideas that work for all of us. What does that mean? We are the only major country on earth not to guarantee health care to all people. Poll after poll shows the American people want a Medicare for all single payer system. We got millions of people in this country working for starvation wages, got to raise the minimum wage to a living wage. We've got to rebuild our crumbling infrastructure. We got to make public colleges and universities tuition free. And instead of giving tax breaks to billionaires, you know what the American people want? They think billionaires and large corporations should start paying their fair share.
So this is how you think you beat President Trump?
This is how I think Democrats move forward in bringing the American people together and creating an economy and a government that works for all of us, not just the 1%.
I want to ask you about running for president, but I don't want to ask you the same question everyone already asked.
Good.
Are you running? Are you running? Are you running?
Thank you.
Have you made up your mind? Do you know the answer to that question?
As of this moment, no. I mean, you know, running for president is not a simple decision. You don't say, hey, I'm going to run for president. You got to communicate with people all over the country. I've got to know that the issues that I feel strongly about, income and wealth inequality, a corrupt campaign finance system, the fact that a middle class continues to shrink, the greed of Wall Street and of the pharmaceutical industry, who rip us off every day with the highest prices in the world for drugs, are those resonating with the American people? That I've got, and I'm not quite sure. I think they do, mm-hmm. but, you know, we got a little bit more work to do.
So you don't know?
At this point, no. You know, we just came from an election where people turn on their TV and all they saw is TV ads and all that stuff. The media pushes this a little bit more. The American people do not want never-ending campaigns, you know? Mm-hmm. They really don't. So I think we can give the American people a time to catch their breath and focus not on individuals, focus on the issues. Why are we the only major country on earth not to guarantee health care to all people? Why are our people charged the highest prices in the world for prescription drugs? What are we going to do about the crisis of climate change? Let's talk about that.
Senator Bernie Sanders, independent from Vermont. We've already taken up too much of your time. No. Thanks for being with us. Oh, and let me just say, the book, which we did get a chance to talk about and went over, I think, at length, Bernie Sanders, Where We Go From Here, 2 years in the resistance. Thank you.
Thank you very much.